नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवीएन डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ शलाक्य तंत्र, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक टेरिजियम। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज टेरिजियम। इट इज अ विंग शेप फोल्ड ऑफ कंजक्टिवा एनक्रोचिंग अपॉन द कॉर्निया फ्रॉम ईदर साइड within the interpalpebral fissure. Then we discuss the etiology, pathology, clinical features, parts of pterygium, types of pterygium, its symptoms, the complications, the differential diagnosis, and the differences between the pterygium and pseudopterygium. Today we will discuss the treatment of the pterygium. So what is the treatment of pterygium? The surgical excision is the only satisfactory treatment which may be indicated for cosmetic reasons. We'll do the surgery because for the cosmetic reason. Second, continued progression threatening to encroach onto the pupillary area. Once the pterygium has encroached the pupillary area, wait till it crosses on the other side. So in case of the progressive pterygium, the fold of the conjunctiva will go on to the pupillary area, and when it reaches the pupillary area, there will be visual disturbances. And when this pterygium will cross the on the other side, then we will do the surgery. Third point is diplopia due to interference in ocular movements. Due to the limited ocular movement, there will be double vision, so we have to do the surgical excision of the pterygium. Then recurrence of the pterygium after surgical excision is a main problem. Means we will excise out the pterygium, but again after few years the pterygium will develop. So recurrence chances are 30 to 50%. However, it can be reduced by any of the following measures. There are many surgeries or many procedures through we can avoid the recurrence of the pterygium. First is the transplantation of the pterygium in the lower fornix. It is called the Mac-Reynolds operation. Is not performed now. So we can do what we can do. We can transplant the pterygium in the lower fornix. It is called the Mac-Reynolds operation. Earlier it was a standard procedure for this condition, but it is not performed nowadays. The operation consists of dissecting the head with the attached neck and part of the body of the pterygium from its bed, and a suture was placed through the head and brought down into a bulbar conjunctiva pocket that had been dissected in fairly to 6 o'clock. The suture was anchored into the superficial sclera at 6 o'clock. The pocket flap was then pulled up over the body of the pterygium and then tacked down to the body of pterygium. So earlier this was done, not performed nowadays. Next is the post-operative beta radiations. Earlier they used to do the radiation therapy, and the beta radiations were used. But nowadays it is not done. And the third thing is the post-operative use of anti-mitotic drugs like mitomycin C or thiotepa. So after the surgeries, mitomycin C or thiotepa, which are the anti-mitotic drugs, they are used as a chemotherapeutic agent to reduce the division of cells. So we can usually this drug is used in the cancer therapy. Earlier it was used but not used now. Then fourth is the surgical excision with bare sclera. We can excise the conjunctiva with the bare sclera. Fifth is the surgical excision with free conjunctival graft taken from the same eye or other eye is presently the preferred technique. Nowadays, surgical excision or pterygium is done with the free conjunctival graft, which is taken from the eye. And next is the recurrent recalcitrant pterygium. Surgical excision should be coupled with lamellar keratectomy and lamellar keratoplasty. In recurrent recalcitrant pterygium, recalcitrant means which are uncooperative pterygium, means which is hard to treat. In this case, the surgical excision of the pterygium is done along with the lamellar keratectomy, means the layer of cornea is also removed. Lamellar keratectomy, it is a removal of the damaged or diseased epithelium and stroma. So the part of the cornea damaged is also removed, means in the form of layers. Or lamellar keratoplasty. Keratoplasty is a replacement of the diseased cornea with the healthy cornea. Next is the surgical technique of pterygium excision. First of all, after topical anesthesia, eye is cleansed, drabbed, and exposed using universal eye speculum. First of all, we have to anesthetize the eye with the topical eye drops. Then eye is cleaned, drabbed, and with an instrument known as the universal eye speculum, it is exposed. Then head of the pterygium is lifted and dissected off the cornea very meticulously. Then the head part of the pterygium, which is on the cornea, it is lifted and it is dissected off the cornea. Here you can see this technique, how they are dissecting the head part. They are removing it, then they are suturing it. In this, they have shown the various procedure. The main mass of pterygium is then separated from the sclera underneath and the conjunctival superficies. Then the which is the main pass or the body of the pterygium, it is separated from the sclera below it and the conjunctiva superficially. Then pterygium tissue is then excised, taking care not to damage the underlying medial rectus muscle. Then the pterygium tissue is excised and we have to take care of the medial rectus muscle. Then hemostasis is achieved and episcleral tissue exposed is cauterized thoroughly. Then we have to control the bleeding after surgery and the episcleral tissue is cauterized. The next step differs depending upon the technique adopted. Next step, in simple excision, the conjunctiva is sutured back to cover the sclera. Simply, we can suture the conjunctiva. In bare sclera technique, some part of the conjunctiva is excised and its edges are sutured to the underlying episcleral tissue, leaving some bare part of sclera near the limbus. In bare sclera technique, we have to leave some part of the sclera bare near the limbus. Third is the free conjunctival membrane graft may be used to cover the bare sclera. In this, the conjunctival membrane grafting is done and we have to cover that bare sclera. This procedure is more effective in reducing the recurrence. Free conjunctiva from the same or opposite eye may be used as a graft. Then fourth is a limbal conjunctival autograft transplantation. It is called the LLAT. It is used to cover the defect after pterygium excision. It is the latest and most effective technique in the management of pterygium. This eye, the limbal conjunctival autograft transplantation is done. And it is the most effective technique. Here are the surgical procedures. In A, there is a dissection of head from the cornea. In A step, they have dissect the head of the pterygium from the cornea. And in B, the excision of pterygium tissue under the conjunctiva. Then in C step, direct closure of the conjunctiva after undermining. In D step, there is bare sclera technique suturing the conjunctiva to the episcleral tissue. And in E, free conjunctival graft after excision, exciting the pterygium. So these are all the surgical technique of pterygium excision. So here completes our topic Pterygium. Thank you so much. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comments box. I will resolve it. Thank you so much.